out there, just arrange it properly. Okay. Let's move to writing. I think another 5-6 minutes and we should be able to meet the time constraint. Here we go. There's a chapter called Kathmandu, and so I thought, why not take something like this? Now we are moving to writing. Okay, now this is sculpture, handicraft, so on and so forth. With just this one piece, we could do autobiographical writing. And what kind of autobiographical writing? About this piece or the dragon or the lion that it sits on. Then you have descriptive writing, narrative writing, a story around this, process writing, how it's made, opinion writing, argumentative writing, for example, for and against would be gods and goddesses should not be decorative pieces to be put in drawing rooms, you know, something like that. A formal transactional writing, your business letters, you know, letter of complaint that this piece was defective, placing an order, creative writing, and so on and so forth. So this is Laughing Buddha. Okay, you talk about it. What's the difference between this Buddha and the other one who looks completely Zen? And then another art form, animations. Beautiful. Show them a video or show them clips like this. It's great for diary entry. Imagine using Beam. Imagine that you are Beam. This has been your day. Could you please write a diary entry? This is just an example. You could use for senior classes, you could use so many other animations that we have. For younger kids, you have Chota Bheem, you have Powerpuff Girls, my favorite Dexter and Dee Dee, anything. You have something like this, do it yourself. So the whole process comes in here. Never get bogged down and say that you just have music and you just have drama and there's nothing else in art. There is so much. This is something I came across today morning based on a certain movie that I saw a couple of days back. The movie was called Akuni, and I was really curious as to what Akuni is. And so I found this video. Imagine showing this to your child. Okay, so you're showing a YouTube video. It's an art form, creating videos and movies. So Chef Kunal Kapoor and Akuni, which is Nagaland food. Okay, now we don't know what the Nagaland food is. You're not to tell the child, let the child watch the video. Now, what is the child supposed to do? This is writing. You could have so many things for the child to write. Look at this. Beautiful. Number 4 is one of my favorites. Number 5 is brilliant. Okay, and number 6 as a task. Okay. They would love to do it. Everybody has their hands on the phone. If they don't, I'm sure one of their parents has it. So it's all good. All right. So we're still with writing. Calligraphy. Show them a quote. In any case, you need to give them a stimulus to create their writing piece on. Show it to them in the calligraphic form. Tell them to create a similar one that is thematically connected. And look at this. Tell them to talk about it, write about it. What is this person like? What does this person feel? Could you get into the mind and thinking of such a person? Do you connect with this person? So they are writing that particular piece. What about shape poems, forms of art? Beautiful ones. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. I'm just opening the doors for you, okay? Shape poetry. Why this particular shape? What is the person describing? Why this particular form has been taken? Why certain words have been put in bold? Posters for writing, mind you. We are sick and tired of balanced diet. Why not a poster like this? Why not something like this about a diary or an informal letter of having visited this event? Story. This is Tagore. Do they know that? I'm sure I didn't know it till I started looking at it. They are proper names. So we are educating our child. I came across children in my family who said, he painted. I thought he just wrote the anthem. He was a poet. But yeah, he painted. Look at this. Brilliant. Informal letter, story, speech. These are all art forms. My favorite, I'm going to conclude with something like this over here. Art and the Pandemic. By the way, these are actual acclaimed artists. So what is the writing that you could ask the children to do? Dialogues. What is the person thinking really? What is the person thinking? What's the person saying? And then share with them what the art form is. it's Madhubani and this is Pattachitra. They will go back and find out what's the difference between the two. Okay. Now that we've finished that, in the last 1 minute, I will take you to what you are most comfortable doing, skits and plays. But remember, if you're integrating art, what is the source of art here? So it is this particular poem, Legend of Northland, which I've taken as an example from class 9. And I would say reading, writing, art, direction and casting, stage management, acting and dialogue delivery. So this comes in your listening and speaking. All right. Have another example. Storytelling. Do we know that these are the art forms of storytelling? Can we not tell our kids to follow the elements of this particular art form? Of course, this is not going to be Urdu. It will turn to English. But there are certain do's and don'ts in this kind of form. So they will read it up. They will research it and they will go on. What kind of questions can you give? Have a look. It is not just telling the story. You could connect it to your chapter, convert it to a complete unit, tell the story in part, do a monologue. Or what happens after? Some characters talking about the experience of one and into the mind of the writer or poet, and you could have this kind of storytelling, once when the writer was and so on and so forth, right? Coming to the project, I'm sure everybody is clear about this. I'll take this up in questions later whenever Matthew permits. Classes 1 to 8, it can be transdisciplinary, okay? It needn't be specific to one particular subject, but for 9th and 10th, there is one project, art integrated project for every subject under the Shreshth Bharat thing. For example, Delhi has Sikkim, and it's to be marked in the internal assessment, which is subject enrichment. And for English, subject enrichment translates to listening and speaking. So obviously it means that your art project is going to be integrated with listening and speaking. The integration of art in the teaching of English will carry on. But for this particular project, yes, the details are all there in the circular. I'm sure you could page Matthew later if you want details. We could probably do like a 20-30 minute session just on the project with some ideas. So this is important. Follow these steps when you create your project. You will never go wrong. Just follow these steps. It's there in the circular. Please don't worry. It's there in the circular. Should you need someone to shed more light, I'm always available. No worries there. We could even discuss certain examples later. Okay. And your questions, I'm going to stop here. Matthew, I hand this over to you. Thank you very much, all of you, for your patience.
I knew you had to speak a lot more, but unfortunately, we are running out of time. So we'll take up one or two questions before we go to the next speaker. Any questions, if anybody would like to ask, they can unmute themselves. Probably we can take one question or two, and then we'll see in the end. If we have time, then the whole time will be available. Yes,
can ma'am. I ask a question, Mr. Matthews?
Yes, ma'am. You can ask your question.
Yeah. Actually, most of the circulars talk about till 8th and 10th and 9th and 10th, but there's very ambiguity about 11th and 12th. So I just wanted some sort of clarity on that, if it can be done.
As far as I, so far, I don't think there's a project there, okay? But there is definitely an issue with, there is definitely a suggestion very strongly that says, integrate art into your pedagogical practices. So you have to use that in your day-to-day learning, and which is what they will ask for, when they ask for your pedagogical plans and so on and so forth. The project, I think, is from classes 1 to 10. Yeah. But then we await more circulars.
Yeah, I think that's pretty clear in the circular also. They have said that project in 9 and 10, 11 and 12, art integrated learning, 11 and 12. There's no project mentioned. And as ma'am says, that let's wait for further instruction. As of now, there's no project mentioned for 11 and 12. Any other question? Quick question. One quick question. Yes.
Sir, I'd like... sir, I'm Ritu Bhandari. Could I ask
a
question?
Yes, ma'am. Please ask.
Sir, just as you said, no project is compulsory, but we will still be having ASL for 11th and 12th. Yes. So art integration automatically, even if we don't have a project, whatever way we are integrating art into the teaching of the language, we can include that in one of our ASL, or we will be getting separate guidelines for ASL.
No, no, just go ahead, do the good deed. You'll be doing yourself and everyone a big favor if you're integrating it in your day-to-day learning, Ritu. It's going to be great. Please go ahead and just roll it, you know.
I have a question here. Shall I, Matthew, sir?
Yes, ma'am. That's the last question. Yes.
Yeah. Hello, ma'am. Ruchi, ma'am. It's nice listening to you. And it was an amazing workshop which you did it with us. And all our doubts have been clarified. There's so much to do, definitely. But my question here is that there's a slight doubt here that have we to do this art integration in all the subjects up to class 10, or just one project to be done up to class 10?
Right.
Is it just one project, or is it in every subject we have to do a project?
Yeah. So the circular, I think the part in the circular which deals with all this is 4.1 onwards, if you look at the circular. So what it says very clearly is 1 to 8 can be transdisciplinary, meaning that maybe English could sort of combine with social studies and maybe music and then create one, right? And the other subjects came up with so on and so forth, yes?
Okay.
But for 9th and 10th,
yes,
subject needs to have an art integrated project, which is going to be a part of their internal assessment. For us, it's in subject enrichment, and therefore it comes down to what is our subject enrichment? Listening and speaking, right?
Speaking.
So our project, for example, if it's Sikkim, our project is going to be designed along the lines of what the child is going to speak and listen to when it comes to the art, craft, festivals, etc., culture, food, whatever, of Sikkim. So when you design your project, they are discovering Sikkim. We are this art integrated project, which we are assessing in the form of listening and speaking. Be careful. It cannot be a one-day thing, because the circular form says, how long does your project go on? 1 month, two months, there's a 6 month, you know,
So time period has been given.
Thank you, ma'am. I think we'll take up more questions right at the end, because we have three more speakers and they are waiting very anxiously. So we move on to our next speaker.
Thank you so much, Ruchi, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Ruchi, ma'am, I hope you will stay till the end. I hope you're not too busy. Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
So next we have Dr. Sandesha. I mean, we are very happy to have her. She's a professor from JNU and specializes in English language teaching. And she has a PhD in syllabus designing and for communication skills. And she conducts lots and lots of teacher training workshops and is also preparing students for IELTS, GMAT and CAT. So again, a long list of credentials, but just to keep it short, I will hand over to Sandesha, ma'am. Ma'am, please.
Right. Thank you so much, Dr. Matthews. And I must say, to talk after Dr. Sengar is like way beyond me, because it was amazing the way that within those 25 minutes, she completely, you know, she introduced us to all the skills that we need and how to help the teachers to actually plan the entire, you know, the methodology was wonderful. Thank you so much, Dr. Sengar. Even I learned a lot. It was a pleasure.
There's no doctor there. I'm quite a commoner.
Ms. Sengar, then sorry, ma'am. One clarification, that is, I'm not a professor, I'm an assistant professor. We are also very particular in JNU about that kind of a thing. So I'll just make that part clear. So I'll begin with my time right now. And one thing I would like to say is that I do have an activity. In fact, I have two activities. So depending on the activity and how I start, if I feel that there's not enough time left, I might actually request everybody to leave the meeting and rejoin, because it would not be right to begin in the middle. Ms. Sengar was wonderful the way she handled it, but I think in the middle of an activity that would be a problem. So with everyone's permission, I'm going to share my screen. Just give me a second, please. Great art, and this is one of the most well-known arts in the world. In fact, it is a world heritage, and if people who recognize this is actually Michelangelo's famous The Creation of Adam, which which is on the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. And throughout the journey of this session, you will realize why I have taken this particular one. As Ms. Sengar wonderfully put it, you can actually use these kind of forms to not only talk about the English language, but also about, let's say, history, combining with any other mathematics or science. So this is the power of the language, be it English language or any language. And we're looking at the cognition skills being developed. So going ahead, the art integration in English, and I thank the organizers for inviting me for today's session. Now, what to expect in the next 25 minutes? I would like to talk a little bit about 21st century life skills. I would like to talk about the role of art in teaching, an activity, an art in online theater, another activity, and a brainstorming session if possible. And I'll also mention my sources. Now, when we talk about 21st century life skills, why did I want to talk about this particularly is, in fact, I have been talking to school teachers and other people with regards to what is their mindset about, why do you think CBC, why do you think NCRT brought about this art integration in different languages or the entire academics of schools? There is a reason why. And the reason is because of this particular thing, the 21st century life skills. This is as per in 1997, the World Health Organization, they declared this to be the ability for adaptive and positive behavior that enables individuals to deal effectively with the demands and challenges of human life. And we are talking about the way the movement is just happening. We initially, humans were into an agrarian kind of economy. Then they went into an industrial kind of economy. And now what you've been seeing is the technological world. So the movement which is taking place, we need to enable the generation to kind of adapt to it. And what are the kind of skills that we're looking at? We're looking at the cognitive skills. We're looking at the emotional skills. We're looking at leadership skills. We're looking at creativity skills out here. We're looking at collaboration. We're looking at social and civic engagement. Now, the art integration, whenever you think of any particular activity, you're all talking about projects. You're all talking about kind of assignments or maybe even, you know, so when you're planning, maybe planning it for a group of children together, school students together, would actually enable them to actually build up on these life skills. So this is what I wanted to talk about. Now, coming to the part about, I spoke about when it was, what it is, why, who, how. Okay, so this is what I went. Now I'll come to this particular thing, exactly how Ms. Sengar said, I'm not going to go into the theory of it. All of you would have the link of this. This is the Art Integrated Learning Guidelines. Now the language skills, even this particular image was shown by Ms. Sengar. You all know about the four, listening, speaking, reading, writing, exactly that same order. You have two which are inputs and you have two which are outputs. As English language teachers, we know that every time after a few sessions, we'll have somebody, a parent coming and saying that, when do we feel that our child will be able to pick up the English language, especially with students, from the EWS category maybe. So one of the things is that you will ask the question that, is your child listening to things in English language? Is your child reading things in English language? If they are not, then how can you expect an output? If there is no input, there is no output. The communication skills, as you know, the oral skills, the written skills, and non-verbal skills. In oral, we have the presentation, we have audience awareness, we have critical listening, we have body language. In written, we have the academic writing, we have revision, we have critical reading, we have presentation of the data. In non-verbal, we have audience awareness, we have personal presentation and body language again. Now, in the total communication process, as you would all know by now, everybody, we're all teaching our students how to speak well, how to read well, how to write well. What about listening? Nobody's paying attention, whereas listening is what is 45% and speaking is 30%. Reading is just 16% and writing is 9%. I already see Ms. Sengar applauding me, I guess, because she truly believes in that too. Thank you, Ms. Sengar. Now, ladies and gentlemen, time for a quick activity. Please, everybody, what I would request everybody, Dr. Matthew, could you please put this in your, post it in the Google, the chat box, please? I will stop this and... So there is a quick thing that I want to show all of you, and this is going to be in the Google form. Sir, have you done it? Have you put the link which I had shared with you? If not, not a problem. Everybody, I'm sharing a Google.
I have posted it.
All right. Okay. So everybody, there's a Google form link over here. Please click on it. There's a quick questionnaire kind of thing which is going to come up, and I'll explain to you why I've done that. All right. Now we are talking about helping our students to, you know, so first I want to confirm that our teachers are completely, you know, in with the entire thing about how art can be used for teaching languages. So here we go. few of you might have already begun. Let me just check if you started responding to it. I hope people have started clicking on the questions. You'll have to open another maybe page to do that. I'm waiting for a few people to respond to the Google form. Till then, I'll quickly show this. Okay, to the ones who are not able to maybe start with the Google form, this is the Google form which was created. If you have clicked on it, you would be answering this and I would be seeing the responses immediately, all right? Most of you are already doing such things. For example, the question which I asked was, one of the first things, have you begun using art in your teaching methodology? Yes or no? If yes, then how? Please just give me one or two lines. Don't worry about it. Maybe that is the reason why you're taking so long. And if not, then how do you plan? Maybe you are waiting to hear Jamila ma'am and Ruchi ma'am, then to get inspired and then to come up with ideas. Not a problem. Maybe you've already started thinking because Ruchi ma'am did a wonderful presentation. So maybe you could talk about how do you plan that. Now coming, oh wow, we already have one response. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm waiting for more. I'm sure Dr. Matthew is going to give you a prize later. Now looking at this particular art talk, this is the same spoof of the same image that I'd put up initially in the starting, which is the Michelangelo's famous, The Creation of Adam. What according to you is the best message which is depicted in the above image? The options are, one must always use cream to soften one's hands. Second, importance of sanitizers. Third, sharing is caring. All right. Now, these kind of questions are what kind of, you know, get everybody to think about things and everything. So I just wanted to have a little bit of fun with everybody and make them learn in the process. You obviously might have more different kind of questions. The other question which I'd asked was time to be creative. All right. Now, the same spoof again, based on this image above, name the artist and the title of his work. Okay, I've already given you the answer, by the way, and that has been made a spoof, and also give a title for the spoof. So like how earlier ma'am was talking about getting the juices, creative juices flowing, you could actually get your students to think about it, because a lot of students of ours are already looking at all these things. They're all internet savvy. They're already coming up with all these creativity and these creative ideas. So as you can see, technology has now taken the place of God. That's the whole point of this, as you would have already known. Then I requested people if they had time to give feedback. Now I'll quickly come to the responses. Wow. So one of the things about this Google form quickly, which ma'am had also kind of shown, she had given you MCQs. So those MCQs would fit perfectly out here. You would come to know what are the average, what are the medians, the frequently missed questions, the names of the people, their marks. So I asked you people, have you begun using? And interestingly, already we have got 77.8% who say that yes, they have started. But at the same time, we have 22.5% who say that no, we haven't. Okay. And if yes, then how? So they have obviously given their different reasons out here, which I'll share with everybody later with Dr. Matthew's permission. Then what according to you is the best message which is depicted? And everybody, mostly 16 people have got it right. We have one person who has written about cream, and obviously no one took sharing is caring. And wonderful, people have given the name of the artist. Okay, so I just wanted to give you that quick thing. Now I'll stop this and I'll come back to my presentation. Thank you so much to the people. You can continue doing this later. Now, let me come to the part about art in online theater. Is this is the screen fine? Is the presentation being seen?
Yes, ma'am, it's fine. You can go ahead.
Okay, thank you so much. Now, coming to this part about art in online theater, I love the way ma'am talked about it. And she talked about like creating, you know, shadow puppets and everything. So let's go a little bit notch higher. Now we have students in the ninth grade who are actually going through books like this particular one, Beehive, and then we have another one which you know is Moments, okay? So I've taken two particular stories from there and I've kind of created some activity. So you could actually get your students to be inspired and create backdrops, create groups. Like you could have 3-4 people being a group, another 3-4 being another group, and then you could tell them, hey, this is a story. Each of you take a portion of it and, you know, create the dialogues. If the dialogues are not there, you create the dialogues. While they're creating the dialogues, they could actually also come up with, as you know, and just give me a second. For example, this is how it go about it. Now, behind would be the background which I created. Unfortunately, this is not the one I created. I've just taken it as just an image. And I would read out something if I was acting it out, and I would say, on Sunday afternoons, grandmother sent her down to the drawing room to have a nice talk with father and mother. But the little girl always found mother reading, and father, as you can see the father, he stretched out on the sofa and his handkerchief on his face, his feet on one of the best cushions, sleeping soundly and snoring. So this would kind of create that kind of drama feeling, because right now the situation we are in, we're not going to be able to sit together in an audience. And this would create that feeling of, yes, okay, there's an activity happening. So similarly, since we don't have much time, I won't go to the second background. I'll go back to my original one. This is from another story, but then again, I'm not going to go to that one. Now, another quick activity. I need to know how much more minutes are left before I do this particular one. I think another maybe 5-10 minutes would be there. Yeah, then
have,
we can do
it. You have 10 minutes, ma'am. You can have 10 minutes.
Okay, excellent. So quick, everybody, fastest finger first. Everybody go to menti.com. You can do this on your mobile. You can open it up on another slide, and I'll show you how this goes. All right? What you would need to do is, you have to type menti.com. Miss Sengar is already ready. I think she wants to win the prize, right? And the code is 343719. This is what it will look like when you type menti.com. Over here, you put the code 343719, and this is what you will get as the first page, all right? Sir, you've already put down the code, I believe, in the chat box, correct? Okay, not a problem. Meanwhile, I am going to menti.com myself because I am the one who has to handle this. All right, everybody, here we go. One second. Now, if anybody has already tried menti.com, that's very good. If you haven't, then this might be your first taste at it. Once you came to menti.com and you put in the code, you have a different section. I am the one presenting, so I have another kind of a section right now. This is what you would have when you are presenting, all right? I have to do this so that I can start that. Now, I'm starting the test. Now, wow, excellent. Already 15 people are giving me their heart emoji, that the dhak dhak sign out here. Very good. Thank you so much, everybody. So I'm going to wait for a few more minutes. Everybody keep, you know, getting in. Now, this is the kind of thing. What you could do is you could get your students to read a chapter and create a test for their friends. Why not get them to be creative? Why not create more teachers from within your students? Because we are all going to be learning with each other. And, you know, so already we have 40 people who have logged in. I'm going to begin with the quiz quickly. Now, one of the first things it'll ask you is it'll ask you to type in your name. All right. So please give in your first name. Don't just give your initials because they could be somebody else. For example, I'm Sandesha Raipa. Somebody could be Sanjana, you know, Ray or whatever. So SR, you know, it'll become too common. And Dr. Matthew has to give you a prize. So please make it clear that this is your first name. All right. Choose your emojis. We have 50 people ready to start the quiz. And once you wait for the people to log in and you start the quiz, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to start, teachers. The fastest, okay, this is not just about getting the answer correct. You also have to be able to kind of, now this is to do with the 9th standard story, which is from story, do you think this scene is taken, right? People who are familiar with the story would get the answer. Others might have to guess, but don't worry. 3, 2, 1, all right? Was it the last leaf, the lost child, or the beggar? And the answer is the lost child. Okay, so that particular scene was from the lost child. A leaderboard will show you the winner. And the winner is going to be, oh, wow. I think it's Parul. Parul and Saba Syed are quite close. Okay, neck and neck. Very good. Now we go to the next question. I'm only giving 2 quiz. By the way, I'm using a free menti.com, so I get 5 quiz. What is the name of this character from the story titled The Last Leaf? Okay. This character, was his name Mr. Johnsy? Was his name Mr. Berman? Or was his name Mr. Behrman? All right? Like S.T. Berman, R.D. Berman? two, one. Your time's up. And the answer was Mr. Behrman. Very good. Our teachers know their story. And the fastest person out here, again, between Farul and Sabah Syed. Very good. Sabah Syed has become a bit more fastest than this. And I think she's... Oh, Namita Chabra. Suddenly from the back. Very good. All right. Excellent. Now, quickly, everybody. I didn't want to take too much time, so not five. I only asked you two questions. This is a word cloud. One word to describe what art integration in English means to you. I have given you options to put in two words as one. Interesting. All right. Good. So art. Learning. Creative. Wonderful. Confusing. Oh my God. All right. Baffling. Learning. Fun. Okay. Excellent. Colorful. All right. So this art integration for you is different for different people. It's completely understandable. It's a new thing. We're all adapting. Hats off to your teachers, the way that you have adapted to the entire online learning mode. Trust me. I salute you, school teachers. I, as a university faculty, learned from the teachers of my two daughters. I have no shame in saying that. I've been saying that to everybody. All right. Okay. Now let's go to the next one. Do you think it is a good idea to integrate art into language teaching? Yes or no? All right. There are people who actually have their different minds and they do not believe that it is right. But most of you, I think, would believe it is true. I mean, otherwise you wouldn't be here. So excellent. I think everybody has given us a yes out here. One person might have said no, not a problem. It's understandable. We all have our views. All right. Now, everybody, ask me anything. I'm not going to take up all the questions, but just to get you the feel of how we can do this. One of the reasons why I took the two pictures from the chapters is because I didn't have time to draw them or create artwork. But what you could do is, like how Ms. Enger was saying, you can ask your students to create that kind of a, you know, artwork for that particular question. All right. Thank you and all the best to everybody who...
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for a wonderful... It was really, really, really interactive and good. I'm sure everybody enjoyed. So we just have a lot of time. So if there is any question, I mean, we have about 4 minutes left. So I'll just allow two questions. If there are... Ma'am, you want to say something?
Yes, yes. Actually, the presentation is not over.
Sorry to interrupt you. Please.
No. Don't worry about it. Not an issue, sir. Not an issue. Okay. So that was just a way to kind of show everybody how it is possible to kind of create projects in which your students could develop quizzes. All right. Your students could know more about it. Now, this is one particular site which I found, which is very good. It's from one of the universities in New York. And this is about art as a tool for teachers of English language learners. I am sharing this with all of you. It has some wonderful strategies, which I think would be wonderful for all of you. All of us, you know, we need a catalyst. We need people like Ruchi ma'am and Jamila ma'am to kind of put that, you know, spark in us to kind of think. And once we start thinking, there's so many things, wonderful ideas which can come about. All right, these were the sources. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for your time. And as I was showing you, this Michelangelo, the adaptation could be anything. Once you start, anything is possible. Thank you so much, everybody.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It was really wonderful, very interactive. We'll have just one question since we are running out of time. Anybody would like to have ask a question, please go ahead. Otherwise, we go to the next segment. We're running out of time. We have 2 minutes left. Anybody would like to ask a question?
I'd like to ask a question. Yes, so ma'am. We are going through all kind of innovative teaching methods, but CBSE board, the style of questions remain the same. Somehow down the line, I feel that we're just working towards them falling in love with the language. But somewhere CBSE board questions don't reflect that.
Well, ma'am, as far as CBSE reflecting the kind, you know, the questions that you're talking about, what I was more or less talking about is how you would create that spark within your students to actually want to learn that particular topic.
Yes,
want
to yes. What totally CBC, agree on that.
What the CBSE decides later is their business. They are the ones who will tell us, okay, these are the questions, how you'd go about it. For all you know, tomorrow CBSE might say that, okay, we want you all to start giving your questions via Google form. Then we adapt to that. If tomorrow they say do it by this way, we adapt to that. What can we do? As teachers, we all have to adapt. What we were talking today is about how to help you teachers to think of creative ways, how we can discuss among ourselves and, you know, create that spark within us. That was the whole point. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your question.
Right. But wonderful, wonderful presentation, ma'am. Thank you. We've learned a lot.
I'm sorry. 25 minutes was really, I couldn't do much. I mean, I think, I was trying to like just make sure that people kind of got into the habit. I think Ms. Zengar was able to bring the entire world to you guys, but I was just trying for a little bit. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Can I answer that in 30 seconds for Ritu about the concern about the questions, with your permission, Matthew and Sandesha?
Yes, please go ahead. Please go ahead, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Ritu, it's like this, that CBSE is moving towards, according to the new curriculum that's going to be out, what they are planning to do now is they are planning to shift to more competency-based education, which means that the learning is going to be mapped to the objectives, the outcomes and et cetera. So therefore, and especially when it comes to critical thinking and creative thinking, et cetera, as 21st century skills, what's happening is that they are shifting their kind of questions to more objective questions. As you might already see the change in the reading section, it's already happening. And it is also going to happen in other sections as well. We've already started the PISA, where the critical and creative thinking is already happening. So the target is 2023. Given